Sending astronauts to space used to take a computer the size of a washing machine. Now, that same computational might can be packed into something as small as an iPad. But as we aim for smaller devices, we're hitting a threshold. Our current materials and techniques may not allow us to continue to progress at this pace. And because of this, we're being pushed in new and exciting directions, like innovating the very stuff computers are made of. Goodbye silicon, hello gallium oxide. Traditionally, computer chips have been made out of silicon, hence the name Silicon Valley. A computer chip transistor needs to be conductive because it needs to be able to pass electric current through the chip. But it also needs to be able to turn off that current easily so that it can send both messages, yes and no, one and zero. These kinds of materials are called semiconductors because they can either be a conductor or an insulator when needed. Silicon happens to be the most abundant semiconductor on Earth. But we've pushed silicon almost to its limit in terms of how small we can get it. We've hit the threshold of Moore's law, the idea that the number of transistors we can fit onto a computer chip doubles every year. That was first posited in 1965 and has held more or less true over the decades. And it's meant that computing power approximately doubles every 2 years. But now, approaching the edge of Moore's law has meant a flurry of exploration into what comes next. A paper published earlier this year outlines a case for Ga2O3, or gallium oxide, which may be the semiconductor we've all been waiting for. One of the properties that makes this material exciting is its large band gap. See, semiconductors have their unique properties because of their band gap, which is the distance between their outermost band of electrons, called the valence electrons, and the conduction band, which is where the electrons jump to when excited to form an electric current. So silicon and gallium oxide are both semiconductors with ideal band gaps to use in computing, but gallium oxide's band gap is larger. This gives it a uniquely high critical field strength and a broad range of possible conductivities, ultimately making it a better future candidate for computer chip scalability. This field is brand new, like a couple of months ago new. But we think that all of these properties mean that you could fit more gallium oxide transistors onto a chip than silicon transistors. And this new material could potentially improve the efficiency of future high-power electronics. These discoveries are still very much in the experimental stages, and the potential real-world applications remain to be seen. Research like this, into new materials and techniques, promises hope. And it's not just new materials in the same computing methods, it's also completely new methods of computing, like quantum computing and optical computing. The upside of being backed into a corner by Moore's law is that it forces us in new directions and into exciting, boundary-pushing territory. Want to keep pushing those boundaries with us? Then subscribe to Seeker, and for more on Moore's law, check out Trace's video here. Fun fact, the original computers used by NASA in the 70s were kept cool by a substance that was also used in blood substitutes for medical uses. Weird. I'm Marin. Thanks for watching Seeker.